Hello. In this video, we will see mechanism of action of GLP-1 receptor agonists and DPP-4 inhibitors. Both the groups are used in diabetes. We will be studying them together because although their direct targets are different, they both ultimately affect the same system, that is incretins. So let's see the physiology of incretins first. Incretins are released from gut after taking food. They include glucagon-like peptide 1 or GLP-1 and glucose-dependent insulinotropic peptide or GIP. GIP has poor action in diabetes, so we will ignore it in this discussion. GLP-1 acts on GLP-1 receptor found on beta cells of pancreas. This GLP-1 receptor is GS protein-coupled receptor. Its stimulation causes activation of adenylyl cyclase. Adenylyl cyclase converts ATP into cyclic AMP. Increased cyclic AMP causes release of insulin. This insulin takes care of glucose that came with the food. Finally, GLP-1 is degraded by enzyme dipeptidylpeptidase 4 found on the vascular endothelium. So this was physiology. In diabetes, insulin activity is decreased. But now we know that stimulating GLP-1 receptor causes insulin release. So we can target this receptor to treat diabetes. One obvious option could have been GLP-1 itself. However, GLP-1 is rapidly inactivated by DPP-4 and its plasma half-life is only 1 to 2 minutes. So native GLP-1 itself cannot be used therapeutically. There are two solutions to this problem. One is GLP-1 analogs, which are resistant to degradation by DPP-4, and second is DPP-4 inhibitors. Let's see GLP-1 receptor agonists first. Drugs in this group are exenatide, liraglutide, albiglutide, and dulaglutide. They are resistant to degradation by DPP-4, so they stay longer in the body. Like GLP-1, they directly stimulate GLP-1 receptors. The drama inside the cell is essentially the same. Activation of adenylyl cyclase, formation of cyclic AMP, and release of insulin. Thus, GLP-1 receptor agonists increase release of insulin by directly activating GLP-1 receptors. Now let's see DPP-4 inhibitors. Drugs in this group are sitagliptin, saxagliptin, linagliptin, alogliptin, tenagliptin, and vildagliptin. These drugs inhibit DPP-4. So endogenously secreted GLP-1 is not degraded. So its effect on beta cell is increased and more insulin is released. Thus DPP-4 inhibitors increase the effect of endogenous GLP-1. Quick summary. GLP-1 receptor agonists are basically GLP-1 analogs resistant to degradation by DPP-4. They directly stimulate the GLP-1 receptor and cause insulin release. DPP-4 inhibitors, on the other hand, prevent degradation of endogenous GLP-1. So effect of GLP-1 on beta cell is increased and again more insulin is released. I hope this clears mechanism of action of GLP-1 receptor agonists and DPP-4 inhibitors. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, we are making medical education as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.